Unexplained band failure in Powerglides is a common problem, but one that can be overcome by understanding the servo pin bias effect. Contrary to popular wisdom that high clutch oil pressure releases the servo on a 1-2 upshift, the truth is that there is always some apply force on the servo pin. Typical modern servos like the C4, C6, and 4L60 have a smaller apply area and larger release area. So there is greater force on the release side to overcome apply force. Little assistance is needed from the servo spring. The Powerglide servo doesn't work this way. It's an older design with an equal seal diameter for both the apply and release sides. This doesn't mean the forces are equal, however, as the release area excludes the area of the pin diameter. With equal oil pressure on both sides of the servo, most of the apply force is canceled out. What's left is a small amount of apply area equal to the diameter of the pin, which means the Powerglide servo actually has a larger apply area and a smaller release area. This pin bias force varies with pressure and can only be overcome by the servo spring. At higher pressures, weak factory springs and some lighter aftermarket springs can't do the job, causing the band to drag and overheat when the servo fails to fully release. The tests to follow show what happens when equal oil pressure is on both sides of a Powerglide servo, such as when the transmission is in high gear. The gauge measures pressure, and a dial indicator is fixed to the end of the servo pin. Movement shown on the indicator represents the inability of the spring to keep the servo in the released position. OE Powerglide springs vary considerably from model to model and are notoriously inconsistent. They also are prone to collapsing if overstressed. This typical OE spring allows the servo to move 100 thousandths of an inch at the common pressure of 215 psi. Keep in mind that each turn of the adjusting screw is 50 thousandths of an inch. This means at 215 psi, the servo is not retracting like it should to its at-rest position. And there is 2 turns less clearance between band and drum than the original adjustment. At 300 psi, the OE spring allows a total of 160 thousandths of an inch servo travel. Things get really crazy with light aftermarket springs or when engine valve springs are substituted. 100 thousandths of an inch servo travel is reached at just 175 psi. And 200 thousandths at 250 psi. The spring allows a total of 300 thousandths of an inch travel at 300 psi. This demonstrates why the servo spring should never be changed to deal with trans brake or staging issues. The spring must be selected based on line pressure. The other issues must be dealt with separately. The Sonnax race-calibrated servo spring is the only aftermarket spring specifically designed to offset the pin bias effect. Watch how the Sonnax spring resists the pin bias force to more than 250 psi. Even at the highest pressure, the pin has moved only 43 thousandths of an inch. The spring has more force at rest and, due to its lower spring rate, less force in the applied position. The result is greater total band apply force and a fully released band in high gear. There's no mystery to Powerglide band failures. They're caused by the pin bias effect. OE and light aftermarket springs allow the wrong combination of forces at high pressures, causing the band to drag and burn. That's crucial power being lost when it's most needed to propel the car down the track. The Sonnax race-calibrated spring is an easy upgrade for optimal servo performance and protection against band failure.